By the end of this video, you should be in a position to explain what a guarantee is, understand the characteristics of a contract of guarantee. Now, these are things that you need to understand if you are in business, because they will help you to manage contractual risks. For instance, if a subsidiary company is bidding for a given contract, but their credit score is low, so the procurement department can get a guarantee from a parent company to reduce the risk in relation to the particular contract. So let's talk about that. Let's talk about guarantees. Now, before we jump into the question of what exactly is a guarantee, let's start by looking at this example. Alex and Bree go into a shop. Bree says to the shopkeeper, "Let him, Alex, have the goods, and if he does not pay you, I will pay you." What you have in this context is a contract of guarantee, in which case the primary liability is with Alex and the secondary liability is with Bree. Now, what exactly do you mean by a guarantee? This is a contract by one person to discharge the debt, default, or miscarriage of another. In procurement arrangements, a company could end up with a bank guarantee, which would mean that the lending institution ensures that the liability of the debtor will be met. Okay, in simpler terms, should the debtor fail to settle the debt, the bank will take care of it. The bank guarantee enables the customer, debtor, or the procurement organization, in this case, to acquire goods, buy equipment, or draw upon a loan. What you have to understand in this case is that the use of the word guarantee in itself is not conclusive, okay? This is because when we are doing business, most of the time when people are doing business, they tend to use the word guarantee when in reality they mean warranty. And sometimes legally they even talk about guarantee when they should be talking about indemnity. So that is the reason why it's important, as far as this course is, or rather as far as your studies are concerned, it is important for you to understand the distinction between guarantee and just about all those things we've mentioned. So what exactly are the characteristics of a guarantee? A contract of guarantee has the following traits. The first one, there must be three parties, that is the principal, the debtor, and the guarantor. Number two, there must be a primary liability in some person other than the guarantor. So remember the example we had of Alex, Bree, and the shopkeeper. The guarantor must be liable secondarily. Now, the idea is that the guarantor only steps in to take care of the debt if the principal fails to do so. So like in the case of, let's say you and your friend and probably the person who's selling you shoes or something. So if you're the one who's buying the shoes and then your friend says, if they don't pay, I'm going to take care of these. What is happening is that the principal liability lies with you, okay? And the secondary liability lies with your friend. So your friend is only liable if you fail to pay for those shoes. So that is what that means. Remember, the creditor's right to enforce a guarantee may not necessarily involve the guarantor incurring liability for the total amount of the debt. In order to understand that again, let's look at this example. Jane may guarantee Ben's loan to Kate by the deposit of the title deed to her property. This means that the equitable mortgage will become the creditor's buffer. In simpler terms, in the event of non-payment of the debt by Ben, which will trigger the subsequent enforcement of the guarantee, while Jane may have to forfeit the mortgaged property, she will not incur personal liability in respect of any difference between the value of her mortgage property and the outstanding balance of the debt. Okay, simpler terms again. If Jen, in this case, okay, did give the bank her title deed, which means she's putting the property for mortgage. If, let's say, the property is worth 2 million, as at when they are making that contract, okay? And so the bank is sure that if Ben fails to pay, okay, it's not the bank, it's Kate, right? So Kate is sure that if Ben fails to pay, she's going to take the property because the property is worth 2 million, right? And then things happen and the property value goes to like 1.5 million and Ben actually fails to pay. So Kate only gets to keep the 1.5 million property. She cannot go to Jane and say, look, this thing is 1.5 million, but the agreement was more than that. We need your personal property to offset the difference. That is not going to happen. So that is what that point means. Now, characteristics number three, the guarantor is totally unconnected with the contract except for his promise to discharge the principal debtor's liability should the principal debtor fail to do so. A good example here to understand that statement is to look at the case of Sutton and Company v. Gray, 1894. So S and Company, stockholders, agreed with G that in respect of clients introduced by G, G should have half the commission and as a result of the introduction, and you would pay S and Company half of any loss sustained in respect of them. Of course, this contract had some issues and they ended up going to court. So in the court, it was held that the contract was not one of guarantee. Lord Esher, MR, said that the test is whether the defendant is interested in the transaction, either by being the person to negotiate it or in some other way, or whether he is totally unconnected with it. If he is totally unconnected with it, except by means of his promise to pay the loss, the contract is a guarantee. If he is not totally unconnected with the transaction, but is to also derive some benefit from it, the contract is one of indemnity. Of course, if you go back to the case, you see the defendant obviously had some interest in that contract because it was, if I get you clients, you pay me something. So you see, that kind of explains a connection. Aside from the part where they said, and if you incur a loss, I will take care of that loss, which you might say, but that is a guarantee. Yes, that part is a guarantee, except the former part made it an indemnity. So if you have any question regarding guarantees, regarding stuff to do with contract, let me know. In fact, there is a course on contract law in the video description, so check it out. I'm Moses from Zerite Network, and I'll see you in the next video.